regular with us and have been around, and you see us do the baptism and Lord's Supper together in one service, you see we're doing a little bit different today. And there's no real reason for that other than to keep you on your toes. We don't want things to get routine, so routine that it loses its meaning. And so maybe if there's just a tweak in the order in which we do it, that keeps it fresh for us. But certainly one of my prayers is that we certainly keep baptizing people so routinely that we got to keep thinking of ways to keep it fresh. If you only baptize people every now and then, it's always fresh then. Hey, let's challenge me on this, all right? Challenge myself and Zach and Patty as we plan worship services on how we can keep it fresh. Now, in as much as we try to keep it fresh in the order and make it new and not routine and to you, the fact is that the message of baptism does not change. What we are proclaiming here does not change. But it's amazing. As I've said before, no matter how much the message of baptism doesn't change, and no matter how much what we are proclaiming doesn't change, there's still people who don't quite understand what we're doing here. There will still be people who walk away for some reason or another, thinking that because I got baptized, I'm okay, thinking that there's something special about this water. And friends, I tell you, there's nothing any more special about this water than the water you get out of the sink at your house. Okay? This water has come up from the ground, pump house over here. Fellas came up here yesterday and filled it up, put a little heater in it, warmed it up a little bit. Then they said they had to empty the ice out of the ice maker and cool it off a little bit. I don't know. But the point is, there's nothing different, nothing special about this water. This water will do nothing to Azariah or Hunter. This water does nothing. The water that has been in here when some of you have been baptized did nothing. And if you are counting on this water, or counting on the act of going under this water to save you, then you're mistaken. You're mistaken. And I need you to hear this. What Azariah and Hunter do here today is merely a public proclamation. And I say merely, I don't say that to downgrade what's going on. It's very important what they do. Because what they do is an act of obedience. It's an act of obedience to our Lord Jesus Christ. It's an act of modeling His behavior, something that He has done. And it's an act of obedience because we see clearly in the Scriptures that it's something that is expected that we as believers will do. As believers, we will be baptized, and we believe that that means to be immersed, to show who we belong to and who we've become. We show that we belong to Jesus Christ, that He is our Lord, our Savior, our Master, that my life is no longer mine, but it is His. That's why we do this. There's another aspect of this that I want to hone in on today, and that's found in 2 Corinthians 5:17. The Scripture tells us that if anyone is in Christ, He is a new creature, a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. And that is a great scripture to be reminded of at a time of baptism. Because what that tells us is that something has already happened. Azariah and Hunter are saying that something has already happened in their lives. What they're saying is that Jesus, through His Holy Spirit, has already started a work in them. He's already started this work of sanctifying. They've been justified. They are justified fully. And now He started the work of sanctification, cleaning them and making them whole and shaping and molding them into the finished product that they will be one day. Finished now? No. Finished one day? Yes. And this is merely a proclamation. confirmation that the old me has passed away. Paul goes on to tell us in Colossians that old me has really been done away with. All right, you can go to Colossians chapter 3 and you can read and you can be reminded that this old me has been nailed to the cross. He's been laid aside. He's been put aside as I put on a new me, a new self. And so lots of times we walk around as Christians thinking, well, I sin because the old me is still living inside me. That's a lie. It's a lie, friends. The old you has been crucified, is what you were saying here. You and I say that the old me has been crucified. The flesh has been crucified. It is dead. It no longer has a hold over me. And this is what I need for Azariah and Hunter to understand. That part of what they are saying here today, and listen, they're going to understand it in different ways, and that's okay. Azariah has been coming to our vacation Bible schools, and she's young. She's going to understand this in different ways, and her understanding of it is going to grow throughout the years as her parents grow her in the instruction and admonition of the Lord. As her parents bring her to church, her understanding of this is going to grow and develop. Hunter's 20-something. He can understand it a little bit better right now. He can understand this idea of what it means to be a new person and that this old me is dead and I don't have to be a slave to it anymore. And they come today, on whatever level of understanding they can have, but they come today to proclaim that Jesus Christ is my Lord, He is my Master, He is my Savior. He has started a new work in me. I am no longer who I was. I am someone new, and you ain't seen nothing yet. Come on, Azariah. This is Azariah Liles. Azariah, I have a question for you. Is Jesus Christ your Lord and Savior? You know what I told you. Is he your Lord and Savior? That's about as loud as you. Azariah, upon your profession of faith that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, buried with him in baptism, raised to walk in newness of life.
Pretty much answer that.
Jesus Christ. your Lord and Savior.
Yes, no doubt.
By your profession of faith, that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Buried with him in baptism. Raised to walk. Week after week, y'all. That's up to you.